clima está embora. Hoje eu me sabia dos primeiros irmãos, que me serei esses mais para o irmão, a Larissa e mais para o outro irmão.
My soul comes to you and your right hand rolls me up. But I shall Salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Granted the world is great mercy. And those who were with them who said, "The Lord has risen indeed and has appeared to Simon." Then they told what had happened on the road and how he was known to them in the breaking of the
Jesus.
Shining more brightly than the sun, and he has glory illumined. The Lord asks the paralytic, "Do you want to be healed?" Human existence was not always like this. The first man and woman were created to live in harmony with nature. They were created to be connected and to commune often with their God. Their expulsion from paradise brought on a state of disharmony to the entire universe. Now that we have our own home, we have to do certain chores, for instance, like picking up sticks in order to mow the lawn. And I was grumbling the other day, and Presbytero reminded me of Genesis. "Cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth to you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. In the sweat of your face you shall eat bread, till you return to the ground. For out of it you were taken. You are dust, and to dust you shall return." Today, Jesus performs this great miracle as a foretaste of the reversal, the reconciliation of this curse. I frequently hear this question, and it is a good question. Do we believe that something bad happens to people as a consequence of them doing something wrong? Because later Jesus says, "Go and sin no more, lest something worse befall you," and also about the blind man, which we will read about in 2 weeks. His disciples all asked, "Who sinned, him or his parents, to be born blind?" Yes, it was the Hebrew belief that individual sins were paid for by future generations. Our understanding of the faith today differs. This is an antiquated understanding and interpretation of the law, which Jesus has set us free from. Our fallen human state, which we live in, once exiled from paradise, allowed for death and disease and all these bad things that happen. They are consequences of a universe living in a state which the fathers of the church call a fallen state. Sin meant exile from paradise, and that meant being cut off and not in communion with God. Ultimately, it meant death. But our God did not leave us this way. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Jesus extended his healing hand to so many. He impacted all the generations to come. He redeemed the righteous who lived and died from the beginning of time. As we see in the resurrection icon, Adam and Eve being rescued from Hades. And to those in the tombs, he has granted life, we chant. He conquered death with his own passion and death, and with his 3-day resurrection, restored our connection to the Almighty. The curtain of the temple was torn in two, signifying we can now connect with the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, which begins here, and it is why the priest begins the divine liturgy all together with everyone saying, "Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages. Amen." And it begins with the sacrament of the Eucharist, here, the divine liturgy. Next week, when Jesus will encounter the Samaritan woman, he will explain that the hour is coming when neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem will you worship the Father. He was talking about salvation through the church, his body. Not just in one temple, as was in their time in Jerusalem, the temple of Solomon. But anywhere that the church, the body of Christ, exists, the kingdom of heaven is there. The kingdom of God has entered earth. The patience of the paralytic, who waited 38 years to be healed, represents all the generations of people who waited for the Messiah to save them. His patience represents our patience, living a life which has hardships that we must live through. But with patience comes healing. Had the paralytic given up 37 years, he would not have been healed. We do not know when the bridegroom comes, because he comes in the middle of the night. So we are to remain vigilant. And he will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Let us wrap up all our difficulties and pain and offer them up to the Master, who takes away the sin of the world and can heal all sorts of paralysis. We will be made one with him, but that starts here in this life. We must take up our cross and follow him. We must take up our bed and walk, as he said to the paralytic. We must receive his body and blood again and again. We must remember and feel the love he offers us. We must choose to experience our God here, now, in the divine liturgy, as often as possible. He is with us. He is suffering with us every minute of every day. Only he can raise us up to walk again if we want his light and life. Do you want to be healed? May God make us worthy to be loosed of our paralysis and be healed. He is the doctor of our souls and bodies, as the Doxastikon from last night said. May he grant to us his Holy Spirit, which heals us from every stain and saves our souls. Amen.
Yeah.
heal the sick position of our souls and bodies.
Está la mano de los dos puntos de George. Van a dar la paz con el Señor. Servant of God, Catherine, received the blessing of the Lord.
Thank you.
passed away. We had his funeral on Friday. He used to sit here in the front row with Liz, who was recently baptized. Ever since I was ordained, he was here in the front row. So, and just as a point of information and education, the Trisagion service, for those who have passed away, the Trisagion service is a set of prayers that can be requested of the church to say anytime, any day, throughout the year. The yearly memorial should be done with koliba and various offerings, such as the offering of the wine, the prosperu bread, and the oil for the vigil lamps, and many other offerings that can be made. But the Trisagion service can be offered anytime during the year and as many times as one wishes during the year. And also these prayers can be done in private on a daily basis, minus the priest parts, by yourselves.
Thank you.
Honorable Bodiless Powers of Heaven, the supplications of the Honorable Glorious Prophet of Far and of the Baptist, of the Holy Glorious and Praiseworthy Apostles, the Holy, Glorious, and Triumphant Martyrs, of our Righteous and Godmarried Fathers, of St. George the Triumphant, of our Father, whom the Saints John, Chrysostom, Archbishop, and Constantinople, of the Holy and Righteous Ancestors of God, Jehovah, and Benignum, and of all the saints that have risen us and saved us, for he is good and loves mankind. Christ is risen. We are in the 40-day period of the resurrection of Jesus, so we continue to greet each other with Christos Anesti. In Greece, they have a bad habit of saying, we already said this wish. But it is not a wish. It is a proclamation of faith, which we must continue to say for 40 days and all the days of our life, every single Easter. I'll ask the ushers to please come forward so we may make our offering to our Holy Church. I'm just going to say a few words in Greek, as I know many appreciate a few words in Greek. And also we have Xanthi visiting from Whitestone. Xanthi, say hello, Xanthi. There you go. She is the sister of Gladys. So it is an honor to have the Archbishop of Schenectady's sister here. No offense to our Archbishop. Τα πόδια λόγια στα ελληνικά. Σήμερα γιορτάζουμε την Κυριακή του Παραλίτου και είναι μία από τις αγαπημένες μου γιορτές, διότι αγαπώ τους ίδιους, ιδίως το δοξαστικό από τον Εσπερινό χθες το βράδυ. Και λέει, ανέβη ο Ιησούς εις Ιεροσόλυμα. Επί την προβατική κολυμπήθρα, τη λεγωμένη κατά Ιουδαίους Βηθεσδά. Πέντε στο ας εχούσι, εντάρτες γρά κατέκητο, πλήθος των ασθενούντων. Λέει πως ο Χριστός ανέβηκε στα Ιεροσόλυμα για τη γιορτή. Η γιορτή που μας έρχεται είναι η Μεσοπεντηκοστή σε λίγες μέρες. Και για αυτήν την γιορτή ανέβηκε ο Ιησούς. Είναι γιορτή που έχει να κάνει με την ευλογία των υδάτων, των νερών, αλλά κιόλας είναι γιορτή που είναι, η Πεντηκοστή ήταν μεγάλη γιορτή για τους Εβραίους, ήταν η γιορτή που φτιάχνανε σκηνές και θυμόντουσαν που ήταν χαμένοι στην έρημο. Και η Μέσο Πεντηκοστή ήταν η μέση της γιορτής. Γι' αυτό σε λίγες μέρες θα πούμε μεσούσεις της εορτής. Ανέβηκε ο Χριστός που λέγεται Βηθεσδά και έχει πέντε στοές. Και στις στοές αυτές ήταν πολύ άρρωστοι και βρήκε τον παράλυτο που ήταν 38 χρόνια. Περίμενε κάποιος να τον βάλει μέσα στο νερό, εκεί που ο άγγελος κατά καιρούς λέει, ετάραζε το νερό και ο πρώτος που έδαινε θα έπαιρνε την ίαση από ό,τι αρρώστια είχε. Και έτσι λέει, έπειτα το δοξαστικό, «Άγγελος γάρ του Θεού, κατά καιρών επιφυτών, διετάρτε εν εαυτήν και ρώσιν εχαρίζετο, της προσιούσιν εν πίστη, αυτοί που πλησιάζανε με πίστη». Και για μας πρέπει να πλησιάζουμε με πίστη για ίαση. Το θαύμα, η ίαση και η άδρευση που θα έρθει από τον Κύριο, δεν θα έρθει έτσι κατά λάθος.
πρέπει και εμείς να πιστεύουμε και να πλησιάσουμε τον Κύριο. Και ειδών ο Κύριος χρονιούντα άνθρωπον, λέγει προς αυτόν, θέλεις, και αυτή είναι η ερώτηση μεγάλη, θέλεις υγιείς γενέστε, που το είπαμε πριν, do you want to be healed. Ρωτάει τον άνθρωπο άμα θέλει την ίαση. 38 χρόνια ήταν εκεί. Και ο άνθρωπος είχε πίστη, βλέπουμε, αλλά κάπως η ζωή τον είχε κατεβάσει και λέει, μα δεν έχω κάποιον να με βάλει στο νερό. Πίστευε, αλλά πίστευε στο νερό, πίστευε στον άγγελο, και αυτό για μας συμβολίζει πως έχουμε πίστη μερικές φορές, αλλά έχουμε πίστη στα πράγματα. Δηλαδή, το κερί και μερικά άλλα που δεν είναι της Εκκλησίας. Πιστεύω σε εκείνο, πιστεύω σε το άλλο, στην αστρολογία, ξέρω εγώ, σε πολλά, στην τύχη, ξέρω εγώ. Και ο Χριστός μας κάνει ένα μάθημα εδώ. Δεν είναι το νερό που θα σε θεραπεύσει, ούτε το κερί και ούτε τα πράγματα. Υγιεινά. Είναι ο ίδιος ο Θεός που θα μας θεραπεύσει. Γι' αυτό τον ρωτάει, θέλεις. Και ο παράλυτος του λέει, μα δεν έχω κανένα. Και ο Χριστός λέει, άστα αυτά. Έλα, σήκω. Άλλο τον κράβατόν σου και περιπάρει. Ούτε εγώ είναι όταν ταραχθεί το ίδρο που λέει, βάλει με στην κολυμπήθρα, ιατρής κατηνάλωσα, τον πάντα μου βίων, και ελέος πηχήν, ουκ υψιώθη. Και εδώ μας λέει κάτι που δεν το λέει στο Ευαγγέλιο, πως έχει εξοδεύσει όλα τα χρήματά του στους γιατρούς. Μέχρι και στους γιατρούς ο Χριστός μας λέει, να πιστεύουμε αλλά μέχρι ένα σημείο. Here it says that I do expend all my money on doctors, the paralytic says, and I still have not found mercy. So Jesus is teaching us here not to believe in things first, like the doctors. Believe in them, but believe in Him first is the lesson. Και το τέλος λέει, αλλά ο γιατρός των ψυχών και των σωμάτων λέει προς αυτόν, άψου των πράγματων και περιπάτων, κηρύττων μου την δύναμη και το μέγα έλεος εν της πέραση. Και τελειώνει με την εντολή να κηρύξουμε σε όλο τον κόσμο την δόξα του Κυρίου. Και ελπίζω αυτές οι μέρες να μας εμπνέουν για τη δικιά μας ίαση, αλλά κιόλας για όλα τα τάγματα του Χριστού που διαβάζουμε. This time period is also very special. It was a period of baptism in the Orthodox Church. And so the first Sunday is the Sunday of Easter. Second Sunday is the Sunday of Thomas. Then is the Sunday of the Myrrh-bearing women. These are all resurrectional holidays. But then from this Sunday and on, all the Sundays have to do with water. So he had to go to the pool to receive the healing from Jesus. Next week, the Samaritan woman has to go to the water to draw water, right? And then she's going to encounter the living water. And the Sunday after is the blind man. He tells him to wash in the pool of Siloam after he puts mud on his eyes. So because it was a time of baptism, but also for us as a reminder that through being baptized in Christ and being a part of His body, we will receive healing, physical and of our souls. So there's a few announcements this week. Glory to God for our beautiful church. It looks beautiful, the blue. It looks so clean. And if you stare up into it, you think you're in the sky. So our painters did a great job, and our administration did a great job managing the project. They are finished also with the outside. It has been painted in a very similar color to what it was. If it seems brighter, it might actually be a brighter color, but not by a lot. These colors are very similar, but not exact. But because of the dirt and the soot throughout the years, it has looked darker for many years than the paint actually was. Like they had gone and cleaned a patch, and the paint matched exactly the clean patch. So it looks beautiful, it looks bright, and as beautiful as our building is and will become even more, we pray that the spiritual beauty of our souls and our faith shines, and we receive continuously the light of Christ throughout this period and going forward, that we grow as a church and continue to welcome all within our walls and outside of our walls. All right, we have a lot of people in this city that can be coming to this church. And so through you, through your sacrifice, through your beauty in Christ, may they see God. That's the point of our faith, to see God in the other, for us to see God in the other, and for the other to see God when they see you. So God bless you all. We have General Assembly inside after coffee hour. We have a fundraiser coming up June 4th. It is a baseball game at the Tri-City Valley Cats. They play in Hudson Valley Community College, I think it's called, right? And this is June 4th. I'm selling tickets. I have the tickets here. Some people have had trouble buying them online. The link is working online, but if you want to buy them from us, we'll take down your name, give you the ticket. You can give us the money. It's $45, and you get a full meal, a hat, and all the proceeds go to the continual fundraising for the beautification of our buildings here and the Hellenic Center. And this is an event sponsored also by AHEPA. Do I have any other announcements? Enough. God bless you. Please come forward for the little blessing.
Christ is risen. Good to see you.